Some people want it all. I don't want nothing at all. Thank you, Jesus. Beloved, what's good? God bless you, sir. What's up with you? Man, what's going on, beloved? Peace and blessings to you. How's everyone? I'm not going to wait too long for, because I know a lot of people probably not even available to get on Facebook Live. I'm going to be real quick and just drop this thought. I want to drop this thought. Dying daily. Dying daily. You know, it's definitely a theme of believers in the Word of God and followers of Jesus Christ that you've heard this term that we have to what? Die to self. Or we have to die daily. You know, and oftentimes it's thrown about. We got to die to the flesh, die to self, die daily. But oftentimes, as many times as you hear that, there isn't an instruction given to you with understanding of how to accomplish that. How to accomplish that. So, I don't ascribe this to be the full counsel of God. But it's just a thought. Okay? How do we die daily? Now, some time ago, I did a study, you know. Paul, so where did that scripture come from? Apostle Paul said that in the book of Corinthians. He talked about dying daily, like. Dying to self daily, like. Okay? But a while ago, I did a study on this word, die, or death. And I don't know where I got this definition. This was a great dictionary. And this dictionary had like probably like 10 different definitions for the word death. Okay? But I'm going to focus on two of them. One is a common definition that the word death means separation. You know, a lot of times they use it in reference to Genesis chapter 2 when God said that the soul that sin, he shall die. Be familiar with that. The soul that sin, he shall die. And a lot of people ascribe that death to be separated from God. Because we know that when they sinned, they didn't actually physically die at that time. So some people ascribe that to be a separation from God. But I want you to think about that for a second. If death means to be separated, think about that. Think about that for a second. When you die physically, what takes place? You don't cease to exist. Like, you continue to exist in a reality that's beyond earth. So wherever you go after this life, you continue to exist just in a reality that's beyond earth. Like, so when you die, you in a sense become separated from this earthly reality. Whatever you believe that reality to be, whatever reality, whatever place you destined after here, you become separate from this earthly reality when you die, but you still exist in a different way. Like, so I want to introduce that concept when we talk about dying to self. Why? Because dying to self, it's not like this religious concept where you just gotta deny who God called you to be, like, or you gotta fast and pray and be in a corner where nobody know who you are, like. Jesus said that you're the light of the world, like, and a light, you don't light a candle and hide it under a bushel. You don't light it and hide it, like, it's supposed to be seen. It's supposed to bring visibility to the area around it. So God's intention is not hiding us, like. God's intention is not he just use your body and he don't care about you. No, that's not God's intention, like. But God's intention is for us to live in a different reality than the one that's all around us. We see racial issues, economic issues, calamities, wars and rumors of wars. But God said that as a believer, you can live in a different reality. Okay? Jesus said, if you continue in my word in John chapter 8, if you continue in my word, then you are my disciple indeed. And you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. But that word truth is not speaking of information. Like, that word truth, it means the reality. That word truth means the reality. So Jesus said, if you continue in my word, then you'll know the truth. You'll know the real reality all around you. You won't be blind to the spiritual reality that is all around you. So dying to self means to be separated from this natural reality and live in the spiritual reality. Separate myself from the opinions and the perspective of man and live from the perspective of God. Separate myself by being moved by what I see or feel and live by faith. The Bible says that we don't walk by sight, but we walk by faith. So that's just one thing. So dying to self is walking in the spirit and not walking in the flesh. Dying to self is seeing things from God's perspective and not seeing things from man's perspective. We see death and we get sorrowful, we get afraid, we get sorrowful, we miss the person. And that's natural. It's nothing to be condemned. But God said in Psalms 139, precious is the death of the saints in the eyes of the Lord. We seen Jesus suffer and get bruised and beat and all that for the kingdom of God, for the purpose of God. And it's so horrible, we couldn't even watch it in the Passion of Christ. But the Bible says in Isaiah 53, it said that it pleased God to bruise him. So in God's world, things is diametrically opposite. The natural world, you know, it's work, save money, make wages. God's work, God's world is completely different. It's sowing and reaping. The world said, I got to see it to believe it. God said, you'll never see it unless you believe first. So it's just a different reality. It's a different way of living. Like, so we have to die to this reality. That's what the Bible says. Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Romans chapter 12, verse 2. What is he saying? You got to live from an alternate reality. Like, yes, I know we're in this world, but we're not supposed to be of this world. That's a dead man's reality. Like, that's how we die to self. We in the world. We know how to manage in this world, but we're really not of this world. The world should see us dead. All right. So that's just one thought. But the other thought is what I really wanted to get to. And this was the even better definition that I love. And I believe that everybody listening to this can apply it to their life in some way, shape, or form. That this unique definition, peace and blessings, my brother, this unique definition for death that I found, it means to forget. The word death, it means to forget. And that's so powerful. On the contrary, in the same dictionary, I looked up the word life. I looked up the word life. And obviously, in this dictionary, they had all, you know, the definitions was all the opposites to death. Okay? So the word life was means to be joined together with something. But it also means to remember. So death, it means to forget. And life, it means to remember. Now I was like, wow, that's such a blessing. And I think that we can take from that definition and make it practical in our everyday life. How do we die to self? Well, the definition for death is to forget. There's some things that happened to you in your past that you need to just forget. Like, it's some things that happened to you today that it's best that you just forget it. Like, you know, I always hear people say this. Well, I'm going to forgive them, but I'm not going to forget. Well, then you're probably never going to forgive them. Like, you're probably never going to forgive them. Because every time you remember what was done to you, it brings forth the same reality of when it happens. It brings forth, it resurrects all the same emotions, the same thought process, the same feelings that you had when it happened to you. So, in essence, to remember it is to give life to it. And then we start talking about it over and over. Like, how many times we repeat the same experience over and over? How many times you talk about what that person did to you? You talking about something that somebody did to you 15 years ago. You 35, but you still talking about what somebody did to you 15 years ago. So every time you talk about that, you go back to a reality when you was 20 years old. You give life to a reality 15 years old. And then we wonder why we struggle advancing. We wonder why we struggle prospering. Like, we wonder why we struggle having success, because we're living in realities that's already past. Like, but the Lord wants somebody to forget something. The Lord wants to release an empowerment and a grace upon you to forget. Now look, so I'm not coming off the top of my mind with these things. Like, all these things, I say, God, give me a scripture on that. God taught me that. I said, God, give me a scripture on that, because people need the word. So he gave me Philippians. All right. Philippians chapter 3. It's an account of the Apostle Paul. And Apostle Paul is talking about his relationship with Christ. And check out what he said. He talked about all his accomplishments, how he was the one of the, you know, he was a strong Jewish believer. You know, how he was, you know, he talked about his background, his culture, his lineage, his successes. He talked about all that. He said this. He said, all that stuff is good, but I count it all dung to have a relationship with the Lord. Like, to know Jesus Christ in the power of his resurrection, to know Christ and him crucified, I count all that as dung. Now check this out. Check this out, right? Listen to what he said. He said, in this one thing that I do, I forget those things that are past. I forget those things that are past. I forget those things that are past. And I press toward the mark of the high calling. Like, I said, wow, God, that's powerful. That's how we die daily. Like, that's how we die to self. Like, you die to self by forgetting those things that are past, by allowing yourself to be renewed in your mind every day. Like, every day. How am I renewed in my mind? I have to remember, like, I have to remember what God did for me. I have to remember the precious promises of God. I have to remember the word of God that's been spoken over my life. I have to remember the reality of God's word instead of the reality all around me. I have to remember God. I have to remember these things. And as I remember these things, something new, supernatural will take place. Your mind begins to be renewed and you die. Like, you die. You be separated from this natural reality. Like, so it storms all around you, but somehow you have peace because you're not living in that stormy reality. Like, somehow you forgot it. Like, and you allow the Lord to renew your mind to a different reality, the reality of his word, the reality of his presence. Now, some of y'all saying, Mo, that's too hard. Well, listen, we all had to face hardships in life. We all did that, like, and we was able to overcome, like. So when it comes to God, I don't want, it's really no excuse for us to say it's too hard. We need to do whatever we need to do to advance in life. So how do I do that? Like, he said, I forget those things that are past, and I press toward the mark. Like, so what is a mark? A mark is a goal that has been set before you by God. Like, God sets a standard. God sets a mark before us. God sets something for us to strive to. God sets something that's forward moving, a forward momentum. It's called the prophetic word. Like, a prophetic word is forward momentum. Like, it's revelation that propel you forward into your destiny, into the greater that God had for you, into your purpose. Like, okay? So we remember these things. Like, we fight to remember these things, because when we remember, what do? We give life to them. And then we die to those other realities. So Paul said, I forget those things that I pass, and I press toward the mark of the things that's coming in the future. Like, so what makes it easier for us forget the past when we have a better future to look forward to? That's why Holy Spirit will show you things to come. Like, that's why Jesus Christ will talk to you about your purpose and destiny. He give you something better to look forward to, like, than your past. Now check this out. This is how beautiful this is, because, you know, it's a lot of people in this time because of everything going on in our nation, they saying that, listen, you need to repent. You need to repent. You need to repent. Listen, I'm all for repentance. A lot of us need, a lot of people that saying you need to repent also need to repent too. We all need to repent. But the word repent means to turn, like. It simply means to turn, simply. To turn away from an action of sin. To turn away from a lifestyle that doesn't glorify God. Listen. To turn away from a belief system that is not in line with the truth of God's word. To turn away from an ideology or a thought process or an imagination that is a vanity. To turn, like. But check this out. If I'm facing south, to turn, I have to turn my whole self and face north. So if I do an about face and I turn myself, then just by definition of turning, I'm not facing the same thing, like. I'm not facing the same direction, like. I'm facing a different direction. So my prayer is, God, give everybody something to turn to, like. It's easy to look back at the past and breathe life into it by remembering it, like. It's easy to do that when you don't have something to press toward, like. When you don't have a mark, when you don't have a goal that is set in your life by God. The next thing I want to talk about, this and that dying to self, is new things. The Lord said, behold, I do a new thing. Before it spring forth, I tell you of them. That's in the book of Isaiah. Why? Why does God speak about new things? Because he sets joys before us. God has set a goal before you. God has set an aim for something for you to strive towards. Now check this out. God said, I set before you, right? God said, be a new thing before it spring forth, I tell you of them. Why? This why. Because when he does that, he gives you the grace to repent, like. He give you the grace to refocus, like. He give you the grace to die to self, like. By giving you a prophetic word for your future. In that is the empowerment to die to self. Not by trying to fast or do something religious. No. By just receiving the engrafted word of what God has for your future. And focusing on where God is taking you. It gives you the ability to die to those things that are past. To forget those things that are past. In the book of Revelation, God said that when he make a new heaven and new earth, God said that he'll wipe away every tear, like. What is a tear? Something that happened to you that caused sorrow, like. Something that happened to you that caused pain. God said, I personally, as your heavenly father, will wipe them things away as I do something new. But check it out, what else he said. He said that when we go into the new heaven and the new earth, Isaiah 66, he said that the former things will not be remembered. So as we embrace the new things that God is doing, as God is speaking them, causing forward momentum, causing forward perspective, causing a forward focus, we die in that, and God wipes our tear. God wipes the tears from our eyes from all that caused us pain. And what else? The former things will not be remembered, like. They will not be remembered. So with all that being said, I want to ask you a question. How much time you spend rehearsing what somebody did to you in the past? Life and death is in the power of the tongue. How much time you spend giving life to something that already happened and you can't change it? Like, it already happened. You can't change it. I talk to people and then it's like certain things just trigger them. They'll talk about something that happened 5 years ago, 7 years ago, 3 months ago. Every time you talk to them, they talking about what happened 6 months ago. But if we press toward the mark in God, God will wipe our tear. God will give us the grace for the former things to be remembered no more. And therefore, we die in that. So how do we die daily? We forget those things that are past. We press toward the mark. We embrace the word of God. The Bible says in the book of Psalms that God's thoughts towards one person is as the sand of the sea. And if you read in Exodus 9, and you read in Exodus, when Moses killed an Egyptian man, the Bible says that he buried him in the sand. Like, some of us need to kill the Egyptian man. And who am I talking about? I'm not talking about Egyptians. God bless them. I'm talking about the old worldly nature of yourself, like the old fleshly nature of yourself, like the old consciousness, the old way of seeing things, the old way of responding, like that Egyptian man. Some of us, we need to kill that Egyptian man by burying him in the sands of God's thoughts towards us, burying him in the sand of what God said about your life. Die daily, saints. Peace and blessings. I believe Christ came in the flesh.